right, today we're going to make a clay giraffe planter. So it'd be good, great for a succulent planter or a smaller plant, but we'll start with several pieces of clay. So you want a piece for the body, and I've already kind of pinched off four pieces for the legs, and I'm going to roll those into a coil to start. So you can just put that between your hands and roll here, or if you'd like, you can roll on the newspaper as well. Getting those to a similar length just to start, and then we'll put those off to the side. So you can press forward, pull back, press forward, pull back. I hope you all are enjoying this break. It's definitely been an interesting time, but hopefully we'll get through this well and we'll have a few projects. I'm definitely learning how to hand build and learning all those techniques and spending more time on detail. I hope you're enjoying that part of working with clay as well. All right, so we're working on that fourth leg here. They're not perfect coils, but it's just a good start here. And then as we get closer to attaching them, we'll make them the same length and add a few details as well. All right, so I can set those here. And you can go ahead, you all take your time. This is a YouTube video where you can push pause at any time and really refine what you're working on. I'm working just a little bit quicker here, but I'll cut those to the same length with my popsicle stick on one end here, and then over to the other end here. And now I know they're all the same length. I'm kind of standing up to see how that length looks. Again, we'll be making the longer legs, the longer neck, just giving it those characteristics of a giraffe. So that looks like a good height right there for those legs. And I'll set those to the side. And now I'm going to work on a little pinch pot for the actual planter. So I've got another piece of clay here. And it's a little large, so I'm going to start by just making that the size that I want, putting that into a ball. I'm rolling that on the newspaper here into a ball. So now I'm going to pinch the planter. So I'm going to put my thumbs down inside the pot. And you all know how to pinch a little bowl here. So we'll kind of rotate that in our hands as we're pinching the bowl. And the giraffe body is a little bit longer, so I'm going to make this more into like an oval pinch bowl so that we can sit that on top of our legs here. And you'll want to go with about a quarter inch thickness all the way around, so I'll be pinching that just a little bit thinner. Kind of smooth as you go. Again, these projects, as they kind of dry throughout the week. It's kind of fun. You can go back on the leather hard and add more details. So I'll let this sit out for a little while over the next couple of days, and I'll come back and I'll re-record some more video with adding the details as well. All right, so back to that little base. It's like a little boat bowl to start with. You can even flip it over to work on some smoothing with with your fingertips here. If you really wanted to get that smooth surface, you can also use some of your tools. You could take this popsicle stick and just kind of tap to really flatten that edge, get it nice and smooth. Alright, so I've got the basic start to that, and as it firms up a little bit and leather hard, I will go back and refine that shape as well. I'm going to set that over to the side with the legs. Next, we'll kind of roll a coil for the long neck. That's what we're working with. And you want the neck to be a little bit thicker than those legs because it's going to have to hold on top the head, and we're going to work on the head after the neck. So I'm just kind of pushing that coil back towards me to kind of roll here. And I'll probably keep it a little bit thicker where it's going to attach to the bowl, the planter. And then the head will sit here and attach on the top. Like a good start, and then set that to the side. Now the fun part is we're really going to work on the detail to make it look like a giraffe by working on that face. And then later we'll go back and we'll add the details of the coat or the fur for the giraffe, which has the different colors and shapes and kind of geometric patterns. So we'll do that as it's drying up and becoming leather hard, and I'll add that video. I'm going to grab a little bit more clay here. So, kind of roll this into an oval. And got the back of the head starting here on the side. And then the front, I'm going to start just kind of pinching that forward a little bit. Into like the nose and the mouth area. Kind of smooth that with your fingertips as you go. So we'll be kind of adding clay here, taking clay away, to really start making this more look like a giraffe face. So I'm going to start by kind of pressing in where the eyes would be here with my thumbs. It's just a rough little start there. Okay. Now, I'm going to roll a couple balls of clay to really kind of work on the eyeballs. So grab a little bit more clay. I have a clay sitting over here in plastic so it doesn't dry out. Just rolling those little balls to add into the eye sockets that we pressed with our thumbs. You'll want those similar shapes, so I'm going to add a little bit more clay to make them the same size. I'm going to go ahead and score with my wooden skewer. And I have my water sitting right here, so I'm going to with my fingertip here. If you really want to score well, and use that water, score in both that those pieces where you're adding and then pressing in. This giraffe has rather large eyes, proportionally. It's kind of like a little, my little pet shop type features here. All right, so then I'm going to add some clay for the eyebrows, working on those. Kind of blending that clay in as you add it. Just pinching that eyebrow up over the eye. And adding the other side here, rolling that little coil. Blending the clay into an eyebrow shape here. Alright, now we'll go back and work on that nose and the mouth a little bit here. So there's the start there. So I'm going to kind of squeeze it down here, like making that little bit of a chin. And I'll probably build that up with a little bit of clay too, because that bit upper lip is a lot bigger than the lower lip. So I'm kind of just refining that shape here. Clay that would come down like into the neck. Almost like making a little throat, if that makes sense. Fingertip just to blend all those added pieces so we don't have any cracks later of this drawing. So if you see any cracks on the surface now, go ahead and blend those, because they will, as it dries, turn into cracks. Alright, so now I'm going to work on that upper lip. And using the popsicle stick, I'm just going to make that lower lip smaller than the upper lip, because it can kind of open up a little bit right there. Using just a little bit of water, smooth here. You can also use that popsicle stick up around the eyebrow to refine that shape there. Now, the upper lip, we'll work on that and the nostrils here. So, the nostrils are up a little higher because you want that lip to really hang out a little bit further. So, I can use the end of a wooden skewer. Right on those nostrils. You can see that there. And then I'm going to add a few more coils over just to build that up a little bit. If you happen to have a paintbrush at home, that might be helpful just to kind of smooth and get in these areas with water to smooth the clay. It's starting to look a little bit like a dragon face a little bit, but we'll refine that. We'll add the little horns that the giraffes have, and I believe those are called ossicones. I looked that up earlier today. I was wondering what they were exactly, and that's the scientific name, and I think it comes back from a long, long time ago when they possibly used those as a way to defend themselves. Now, not sure how often they use those to defend themselves these days, but I believe it's a defensive feature that they have. Okay, so you can see it's starting to look a little bit like a giraffe. I'll use this right here, this popsicle stick. I'm going to make it have a little bit of a smile, so it's going to curve up just a little bit on the outside there. It's going to be a happy giraffe. You could make yours mad if you wanted to by bringing that down on the side into more of a frown. You can make it a little happier by bringing that up into a smile. All right, so now we're going to add those ossicones, the little horns that I just referred to. So get a little bit more clay for that. And you're gonna roll some tiny coils. And then you can kind of flatten them at the top. Just by pushing down. Just pinch off a little clay if those coils get too long. Back behind the eyes a little bit here. Scoring well. Scoring on the underside of these little horns. And really kind of pressing those in. So they don't fall off later. You want to blend them well now. And I went ahead and grabbed a paintbrush so that I can blend a little bit more. I'm hoping you all have paintbrushes at home. If not, you can just use like a toothbrush or something like that as well. Paintbrush and water is great for smoothing out surfaces. I'm going in around the eyes, accentuating those eyebrows right now. And feel free, if you are on the Google Classroom, to post any messages that you might have for the class or for me, and just a way to stay connected. I'd love to stay connected with you all over this little break that we're having. And remember, when your pieces are dry, like if you have that elephant, you want to wrap that in newspaper and put it inside a shoebox or something, just to keep it nice and protected so that it doesn't roll over and break. You want to make sure that newspaper is supporting it so that it cannot fall over inside that box. Same with this giraffe. When we finish with this, we want to, because once they are dry, they're pretty fragile until we fire them. So just be very careful with where you have them in your home, maybe up high on a shelf inside a shoebox. Wrapping newspaper or tissue paper would be good. Or if you happen to have any bubble wrap, that's a good product as well. Okay. Now we're going to start on those ears. So I have all this little scraps. I'll put together in a ball. And for the ears, we're going to take off a little more clay. Starting with similar sizes here. Like making it into a shape of an arrow or a feather. Comes out to a little point on the sides here. Move a little flat spot back here so it can kind of sit without rolling. There we go. You can see I'm going to make a little shape here where we can attach the ear. Okay, on the next one, going with that shape of a feather or an arrow again. Creating a little flat space where we can attach to the side of the head. Just adding a little water, blending the cracks, smoothing those out. Okay, so we have two similar ears to start with. And we'll score here. On both sides of the ear where we attach. And I'm going to add a little water. Blending the clay around the back of the head there. Again, feel free to push pause on this video at any time to refine your piece. Alright, so we've got one ear attached. The other side. Take that off real quick and score it. I had not scored it before I sat on there, so I'll score here. Dip it in some water. Blending that clay really well so they don't fall off later. I know some of y'all have had that before. You want to make sure you're always slipping, scoring, attaching well so that it does not fall off later. So the back of my giraffe head's kind of flat, so I'm gonna add a little bit of clay there now that I have the ears attached, just to kind of round it out a little bit. And I want to give the definition on the front of the ears for like an earlobe, so I'm gonna be making a few indentations there. Rounding out the back of the giraffe head now with a little bit of clay, so it's a bit rounded instead of flat. So, work on those ears, making those lobes. I'm going to stand it up a little bit here. And you can use some tools here to kind of flatten and make a little earlobe. Just defining that a little bit there. You can see that I'm using this popsicle stick. General shape there. I'll go over to the other side. So it's beginning to look more and more like a giraffe. Not perfect yet, but you know, when we add the other features with the legs and the neck and then the geometric pattern on the giraffe fur later, it'll really come together. Okay, so let's see, I'm just kind of looking here. The last thing I do, I think I want to add a few little, just defining that eye a little bit more, a depth with like a pupil there, and that will, you can see that one side over here, it's a little bit different now that I've added that depth with a pupil. You can decide if you like that or not, you don't have to add all these features. And you are probably, yeah, I'm even going to find some features that I may forget here, and I can't wait to see how all of these turn out when we bring them back to the classroom and fire them and glaze them together later. Okay, so I've got this head here. And I'll blend those ears a little bit more when it's leather hard, a little more workable. Okay, so now I've got the body, which on these legs, you know, the feet are a little bit wider at the bottom, so I'm going to pinch those out to make them a little wider. So they have something to kind of balance on, surface to balance. I'll set the head over to the side so I'm not rolling that around while I'm looking here. And you can really just draw some of that clay down to the feet as well to make them a little bit wider. So I'm just using my fingertip to kind of pull some of that clay down. Using just a little bit of water. Remember, don't use a lot of water when you're hand building. You don't want this to become too soft or muddy. So there's one. You can see how it's a little bit wider at the bottom there. Grab the next one. And if it's taking you a little bit longer on these legs, feel free to pause that video and catch up when you're ready. Feel free in our classroom, Google Classroom, to post anything that you're working on at home, if you have some individual projects going on, or if you want me to help you along the way, you're allowed to just message our whole class that way as well. Or if you have some good survival ideas for right now as far as how you're staying sane and occupying your time, the fun things that you're doing with your family, or any kind of good hobbies or habits that you've implemented during this time of staying home and staying healthy. So the main thing I'm doing here is getting those feet a little bit wider at the bottom and making them all the same length. So you can see as I widen that foot, we kind of lose a little bit of height, but it'll make them more stable and also more proportionate as well. Alright, so we've got four legs about the same height here, and I think I'm going to build up just a little bit of clay around the knees here. Just adding like something that would look kind of like a little knee joint, blending that. This is an added feature that you can add if you like, but not necessary. Just depends on if you like it aesthetically or not. So now I'm going to score. tops of these legs. And we will attach the little bowl. Now this could be used as a little succulent planter, or it could be used as a little coin holder or jewelry holder. You could sit next to your kitchen sink and your mom can put her rings in the bowl, or if you're cooking yourself, you could put your ring in the bowl. It could serve as a function of whatever suits you best. All right, so I am going to go ahead and add just a little feature on these feet. These are my popsicle stick there. And I will score the top of these legs here. So I scored, and now I'm adding a little bit of water. I'm grabbing that bowl that we made earlier, and I'm going to flatten this, just the bottom where we will attach the legs. And then you'll score the bowl where you're going to attach the legs as well. Blending that clay in. I'm just going to turn this upside down. And you may find that you want to wait on this step when everything's leather hard or approaching that. Just make sure if you wait until it's a little bit more dry that you use a lot of water and scoring and slipping. And if you see any cracks here like this, you want to use a little bit of water and blend that, because what can happen is that dries, is that crack can grow a little bit larger. So just blending that well. Carefully turn it over, and you you can kind of level this out. Got one leg that's a little bit shorter. Do you see that? So what I'm gonna do is just kind of squeeze that clay. We have long giraffe legs anyway, so there we go. We're just gonna squeeze it until it works. And now you can see where we can start adding some pressing that we'll need to join in, adding some different features of how you want those legs to stand. Okay. I'll just be squeezing this to even this out. Then we'll be adding the neck. Can't see everything. I have to scoot back a little bit here. So we'll add the neck and the head. And oh, I'm going to scoot my camera back a little bit further here so that you can see everything. So, I'm going to take a little break here and come back and add these features. But I do want this to set up a little bit longer, so that's why we're taking a little bit break. I want these, the body to kind of firm up and the legs to firm up. And I want the head, it's a little soft right now. So before I start blending it into the neck, I'm just going to let it firm up for a little bit. So you can see where this will take on that shape of a giraffe planter or the bull. Awesome. We'll see you all soon. I'll be back shortly.